Hello and welcome along. Today on Thornton Farm, we have two jobs that we need doing. The first is that we need to clean out our cows and our sheep and our pigs. They're all quite dirty and need a clear up. And the second is that we need to do some mowing. So while it's raining, we're going to do the clearing out of the animals. Before we jump in and do the mowing. Now, I know that yesterday, or in the in yesterday's episode, I said that we were probably going to do some slurry spreading today. What I've discovered is that it's not actually, the grass won't actually take any slurry. So I'm not quite sure why that is, and my conclusion I've come to is that it must be that the grass is fully grown. So we're going to go and try and cut it in a bit. Once we have cleared up our animals and attended to them, hopefully that will give us enough time for the rain to clear. Because I don't really want to be mowing in the rain. But shouldn't cause us a problem to do that. But I would just, I think, prefer not to do it. This, of course, with this cleaning bucket, gives us some extra manure. Oh, and forwards. And it works really well, this cleaning bucket. Couple of passes, and we clear this up, and there we go. Right, so we'll head over to our pigs and clean them up as well. Now, we're also going to have to run down and do the sheep. We should have enough space in this bucket to do everybody. It doesn't tend to fill very quickly, this. There we go. And round we go again. And down. So. There we go. Right. So actually, I think I might tip this. We are fairly full. And I don't want to get all the way down to our sheep and discover that we don't have any space in our bucket. So, let's tip this out in here. There we go. And back up again. Right, so we'll just pop down to the sheep and clean them out as well. Now, for our mowing, we're going to use our big Claas. Because that does have a rear drivability and also very manoeuvrable and will easily run our mowers. I was considering, well, I might run the hay, the tedder behind it as well. But the trouble is with that, of course, it's raining, so that's not going to dry out very quickly. So that's why I really want to wait. Well, that's why I want to mow it and leave it, because then once it's dried a bit, we can get the tedder on there and follow behind and sort that with that. But also, it just really depends on how long this rain lasts. All right, open the sheep gates. We'll close them behind us in a moment. We don't want any sheep escaping. That would not be good. That would cause us all sorts of problems. Wait, and back into our tractor. There we go. There's all got plenty of food, which is good. It is just that they need the... we're not down far enough. They just need their areas cleaning, so yeah, manure is not accepted here. We must have the bucket tilted too much. There we go. And turn. Back round. Oh, let's not go in the water. Right, and down again. We'll get the cleared out. Like so, there we go. So now all of our animals are nicely cleared out. I don't think there's much else they need other than grass. We do need grass for them and corn for the pigs, but we can't do much about that at the moment, unfortunately, until our corn has grown. So everybody's nicely cleaned out. It is just grass we really, really need now. So we will get onto that next. Our sheep are still producing wool quite nicely, which is great. And hopefully some lambs. It being late spring, we should be getting some lambs. Yeah, grass is the one thing we can't buy bales of, so we need to keep that going. That and corn. We can't buy any corn. So the pigs fortunately have enough to last out their breeding for the rest of spring. But beyond that, it'll take until we can get a harvest in. Right, so we will take this and we'll tip it. And then we will go and get our class. So we'll go and park this up and we will get our class out. There we are. We need to keep our bales carefully stored because they do disintegrate on with Seasons mod on this map, because we do have a snow map. Right. So pop this down here. There we go. And we'll just drop our barrel off as well, because we don't need that at the moment. So we'll pop that down here as well. Next to our silage bales. Oh. There we go. Right, and away we go. Head back over to the other yard and get our class ready to do some mowing. Now our mowers, I believe, are in this shed here, unless I'm very much mistaken, which I am. Where are our mowers? We need to go and find those so that we can do the next job. Right, there we are. Turn that off. And there we are in the Xerion. Let's go find the mowers. They're not. Oh, they'll be with the rest of the grass stuff and the rest of the animal stuff in the other yard. So that'll be round this way. Think? No. Oh, yes. I know exactly where they are. Which is why we're now reversing, because they're in this big barn here, which is where all of our stuff to do grass work is. There they are. Right. Okay. So let's look forwards so that we don't... Alright, and then we'll head out to our grass field, which is down this way. It is still raining. But that's alright, for us cutting the grass. The issue comes more when we try to do anything with it beyond that. Here we go, field 11. Right. So we'll turn into there like this. And then with Control B, select the right tool. There we go. And turn around. This is cool. This is the turning cab on this. Like so. So then we are nicely in front of our mowers. Unfold them. Lower them down. And lower them down. There we go. Turn them on. And we'll see if we actually get anywhere with this now. Yes, that is mowing. So, away we go. It's fairly slow to start moving, though. But then this is more like a harvester running like this. Which is very cool. I like this very much. I'm going to speed the time up slightly so that we can get past the rain. While we're doing this. Go around the edges. It's finally beginning to brighten up a bit now. There we are. So we're past the rain now. And the mowing is going quite nicely. Hoping that this, because we did a fertilise of it, we'll get a good yield with any luck. This is slightly weird looking, this tractor this way around, but it does mean that we have more manoeuvrability. And are more accurate with everything as well. Right, so there we go. That's our first round. So we will then head into our second. This is a lot of horsepower for running these mowers. But it does work really quite nicely, and we can see the full extent of our cutters as well, which is something that's not always possible when mowing. So I quite like that, and we are far, far more maneuverable because we're that much closer to the point at which our mowers are. Go. It does. does work really well, this mower on here. It is a lot of tractor to be mowing with, though, as I said. An awful lot of tractor to be mowing with. There we go. Be going up and down the field soon, I think. See if we can't start getting. I think this field is. Yeah, I was going to say, I think it's square in one direction, but I'm not so sure about that. There we go. Getting round. This is doing it nice and quickly as well. And it is taking these corners as sort of pretty much right angles. Now I'm thinking, looking at this, that we are pretty much, yeah, we can pretty much go straight up and down this side here or along the main end. So the other way is along here, but I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to lift and go down the other side. Like so. So part of the beauty of this is that we will eventually, hopefully, be able to run the merger behind it. I don't know, actually, I don't think it will connect up. Doesn't look like there's a tow hitch at the front of the tractor. But then I don't think the merger actually runs on a tow hitch, thinking about it. Right, we've got to go round the telegraph pole. Slow to start. Oh. There we go. Round the telegraph pole. There's a definite bump there. Slow acceleration, but we're doing okay. We should have this field mowed by the end of this episode, which is what we're after. One of our mowers isn't on. I'm slightly worried we may have done the entire field without a mower on. Yeah, we have. Ha! Brilliant. That's awesome. Absolutely. How did I miss that I was doing the field without a mower on? That's good. So we're going to have to go back round and just do some recutting, I think. Yeah, so I'm going to leave the mowers down while I'm doing the end, because I bet. Yeah. There's more, there's a lot more grass that we can get off this field than we've cut so far. I'm glad I caught that now, but we do have a lot to go back and do now. We'll get most of the headlands as we're turning. There are going to be tufts all over the place. Ah, that's... slightly annoyed I didn't turn on the front mower then. That's all right. These things happen, and you just have to go back and correct your mistakes. We will get the vast majority of it. Wait, missed a bit then. Yeah, it'll be the outer ring that will have more tufts than anything else left. Plus anything down the far end of the field that we hadn't already got. Most of the rest of it will be covered by what we do during our turns here. And seeing as we're using a merger anyway, we will be okay in the long run. Just means a little more work now. But I can't believe I did that. I can't believe I left. I left the middle mower turned off. Go down the side and try and include it as much as possible. And try and see if we can tidy this out as much as possible just in what we're doing. Right, avoid the bump. There we go. And much easier if we avoid that bump. But you can see, yeah, you can see the bit where I've missed it. Does run nicely down the middle. So we'll try and make sure we get it all. That's a massive annoyance. It's what happens when you farm and rush. That's okay, we should have enough time to clear up the error. Seeing as this is our last bit in the main body of the field. So just go around, clear up the stuff we've missed. of which there is a fair amount. There we go. That round. And then there's one more bit here. Oh, it's a tough there I've just missed. Make sure we get everything cut. So this we will collect up for grass. Completely collect this up for grass. We're going to probably create hay bales elsewhere, I think. Oh, we want to be on the outer edge. That way. And we'll get all these tufts we missed before. Yeah. Away we go again. Yeah, when you don't turn the mower on. Nice. That's all been got previously. It's not so much, I don't think. Yeah, there we go. Right, so up the edges. Fortunately, this is wide enough to get it, just about. Should be able to catch these middle bits fairly quickly. There we go, and we've got another one. We had to come back around that way. We are still leaving stuff in that bit there, I think. Almost there. Because it's only partly missed that other one, we do have enough width to get that and the next one over. So it's not a total loss, I don't think. There we go. Yeah, that's got all of it. Just, yeah, covering everything. This is what happens when you foul up when you're farming. You gotta go back and you gotta make sure you get it all. But I think we managed to do it. I think we managed to cut this whole field. Yep, there we are. I think there's a little bit down there. That's alright. Yeah, just a small tuft there. There we go. So, let's turn our mowers off. Oh, hang on. There we go. Right, let's turn our mowers off. I think that's got all of it. And lift them up. And fold them. And then we will switch. Oh. Our tractor back round the right way. Like so, and head back to the farm. Away we go. I think we'll give this tractor a clean down before we put it back as well. Which will be, which is much needed, and it also helps with the maintenance of the tractors. We've done 6 hours in this tractor already, mainly because it did a lot of planting early on course play. It needs, 23 hours or 4 days until maintenance. Right, yes. Over here, this way is the pressure washer. There, like that. Turn it off and jump out. Okay. And while I'm washing this down, all that remains is for me to say thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. Please give it a like, drop us a comment, and give it a share. And for all the latest videos and streams from Virtual Farmer, please subscribe to the channel. I will see you next time. Goodbye.